Here's an old TV subwoofer that I got out of a smashed up, I think it was a, yeah, it's a projection screen TV. And in my neighborhood, I've never really seen projection screen TVs. A long time ago, I saw one made by Magnavox, but these speakers were just complete garbage. They were complete crap. They were terrible. But anyway, I'm walking my dog in the park, and I'm just walking home, and it's Thursday, and that's when I go out to hunt for TVs, because in New York, that's a, like, electronics put-out day, and, anyway, so I walk past this little, like, fenced-in area, and it looks like there'd be a flat screen or, like, a big screen, and I'm like, that looks like there's something there, so I try, I'm like, but wait, it's locked, but miraculously, and out of sheer luck, it wasn't locked, so I'm like, let's do this. So I go back there, I move all the wooden crates there in front of it, and it was a big screen TV. And I'm like, hell yeah. And then first notice I see these two small satellites, these two small mid-range speakers that are self-contained. Here's the other one right here. And I look down and I see this big box, like, it just looked like this. I'm like, is that a subwoofer? So I'm like looking around and I see these two wires. I'm like, and I feel this little hole back here, this little tube. I'm like, that's a subwoofer, and just slides out. I didn't get a chance to see what brand the TV was because it was like leaning in front, and crazy copper rodent had gotten to it, which made my life easier. So I didn't have to take out the 100 screws that held it back on. So I just reached in, tore out the little speakers, slid right out. And same with the subwoofer, and this subwoofer sounds amazing. It's a 30-watt subwoofer, believe it or not. And the magnet is gigantic. I put some glue on the little rim of the inner lip of the subwoofer basket, just so it would be nice and sealed, and so it wouldn't rattle, and that works great. So I will show you how well this monstrous TV subwoofer handles. This isn't quite the Sony TV subwoofer, but it's pretty close. I'm gonna plug in my iPad because it has 5% charge left, so yeah. Alright, so plug that in. It's gonna be Suit and Tie by Justin Timberlake. Sounds great on this subwoofer and it shows off its amazing flex. Can't wait till I get you on. You might think it's Sony because if anyone's taking apart those big Trinitrons with like the big little enclosure with like the small speakers in the front and then the big sub in the back. You know, it has that kind of Sony speaker look, but here's how I know it's not Sony. The drivers are not branded by Sony. I mean, it could be Sony, but I don't even know. But either way, it's an awesome subwoofer. 30 watts. The magnet is gigantic on it. And yeah, so rate, comment, and subscribe.